Hello all, this is Alien Butler Blunders and I'm back today for another video. Instead of talking about figures as I usually do, I thought it was worthwhile talking about some of the top trumps I've got. Now, I had the idea of this after picking up this this new Marvel Top Trumps edition which they've released. They used to have quite a few different varieties of Marvel superhero top trumps, but they've recently released some which have quite a vintage appearance, which I think is a lot better. Some very bold, vivid colours in there. And I'll just jump straight into it, yeah. Talking about top trumps, I'm not a huge fan of card games. The reason why I've got these and I keep these is just because I'm a big fan of the films they represent. And they are just quite quality pictures, and I use them for funny things like scrapbooking. I have in the past, and also as bookmarks. I think if you're leafing through a big book and you want to just hold a page, it's convenient just to do that. So that's the way I use it. And I still appreciate them a lot, though, even though I don't really play the game. But anyway, there's for the Marvel comics, they go for some quite obscure characters which appeared in the comics, but ones which have been made popularized by recent MCU films. Like there's Dormammu, who was in the first Doctor Strange film, Nova, who was in some Spider-Man animations, but hasn't actually had a film appearance. There's some other strange ones. There's Destroyer from the first Thor movie, Zola, Spider-Woman, who doesn't have an appearance in the MCU, She-Hulk, who has an upcoming appearance, MODOK, who hasn't appeared yet, and all the classic ones, obviously, as well as some very obscure ones. And the picture quality is just lovely, really nice quality on them, really, really decent prints. They have improved them over time, and the prints of the more recent top trumps are a lot nicer than the older ones from the early 2000s. Well, you know, obviously they've improved their printing presses and things. So yeah, moving on, I also picked up one of these horror ones. Now, this is one of the original retro top trumps, which were from the 80s, I think. I can't remember. I don't know the exact date, but they do have that vintage look about them. I mean, it's not literally retro, it's just in the style of retro. And advertising some of the different ones they've brought back or are thinking of bringing back. And this one's just like a strange array of fantasy characters. Some of them are kind of more specific to films, like 50s and 60s films. Like there's King Kong in resemblance of the 50s film, but some of them are just like random monsters. Like there's The Thing, which is obviously based on the John Carpenter 80s film as well as the 60s original film. But anyway, yeah, they're nice prints, and each one has a vampire on the back of them, which is quite nice. The Dracula card's in somewhere here, I'm not sure where, but yeah. Anyway, yeah, quite lovely, really, quite nice. Some of them are kind of tacky and wacky, but it's got a nice funny quality to it, which I've quite liked, really. Okay, and right, put that away later. Moving on to the next one. These ones are slightly older ranges of top trumps. I think these were, I'm not sure exactly when these were released, but they're much older. Like this was for the Pirates of the Caribbean Dead Man's Chest film, which came out in 2005. And I know this is in the old style. I remember because they used to have lots of them in Toys R Us and things when that was still in business. I remember growing up, and anyway, yeah. As I was talking about, the older prints aren't as nice, they aren't as bold, but they're still quite appealing. So they've got quite a few obscure characters from the films. I mean, it's still nice, still interesting, and obviously they've got their little description there, which is quite lovely. Yeah. And the poster on the back, as you can see there. Yeah, there we are. Okay, and here we are. These are some Narnia ones from the early 2000s film, the first one, The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe. And on the front you've got Tilda Swinton as the White Witch and Aslan. And then the only card that has Oh, wait, yeah, they've all got actually quite an appealing gold print on them, which is quite nice if you can see that in the light, which is a bit fancier than the Pirates of the Caribbean one. Anyway, so and they don't have the same poster on the back of each card as they have for the instructions card, but oh well, it's quite nice anyway. Okay, and finally, I will talk about these ones, which is Deadly 60. For those of you who aren't aware, this was a BBC TV series with presenter Steve Backshall, which used to be on CBBC for a few years. I think they still show repeats of it, but it was quite a popular, enthusiastic TV series about strange animals and dangerous animals and things. And the name comes from the intention to just find 60 really interesting, deadly predators, some of them quite small, some of them quite unusual, and just talk about them. But they had so many series that they obviously went above and beyond that number. But anyway, yeah, so yeah, quite a nice variety of creatures with a good description as well, quite educational. Okay, yeah, so nice prints, nice variety of animals, cool. So anyway, yeah, this concludes my video today. Thank you for watching, and yeah, I look forward to likes, comments, subscribe, liking, comment, subscribing, and I'll look forward to seeing you in the next video. So thank you for watching.